Guys, welcome to another video of Dan Studios, and today we're going to learn about the country that I'm from. I would say the most beautiful island in the Caribbean Sea, with the most beautiful people, with the most beautiful, amazing food. Oh my god, not gonna lie, I do miss going to Jamaica, but we're going to shoot a video there eventually. But today I figured I'd teach you guys some things, and maybe I'll learn something new about my country too. So let's start it off with a classic Jamaican tune. If you guys haven't heard this song, then I don't know, you guys been living under a rock, but this is one of the most popular Jamaican songs. I don't even know the words. Soldiers, I feel that story. Damn, that song got me hyped. But yeah, though, I'm very excited. Like, this is actually one of the ideas I've had for a while. I just wanted to make sure that I do it at the right moment, because you know, I want you guys to learn a little bit about me and the country that I'm from. And trust me, my country, like, we're known for reggae, we're known for great food, we're known for weed, we're known for actual, believe it or not, coffee. So let's take a journey together, and the first thing I'm going to do is play this clip for you guys, and you're going to hear this in patois, and I'm going to try to understand it too, because I'm rusty when it comes to like understanding the dialect of my country. But here we go.
Please flood out everything.
No, hold on. Tell me, you were in, what happened? You were asleep?
Yes, Rosie and her family were sleeping. Waking up, feel water and waking up. Right through the house, through the bathroom, through every door, kitchen door, every door. Everything in the house flood out. Don't me talk about everything. Everything. No bed, no dead for sleep on. Settee, where you could have rest in a phone, where you could have make phone call and video for sure. Everything flood out. I want back every single piece
of. So what happened? You were sleeping and.
We were sleeping.
Yeah, and.
We were sleeping. Yeah. Hear Prince screaming. When Prince screaming, say water. When you jump up and look, there is water. Many water, like Elsha. That type of water was there. I want back everything. Like I will live here. A sunlight street from here 2 months old, just one out of my mother left here from me at 29. Me left sunlight street, so here me never have been seen my yard flood out yet, or any house in the carpet here in sunlight street flood out yet. Never had been seen this yet.
Oh my god, guys, you know, basically I don't know if you guys understand anything she was saying, but basically she was explaining that she her house got flooded out, she's been there forever, she's never seen anything like it. But she said it in such a funny way, and listen, this is why I love Jamaican people, because, like, honestly, like, we're very, you know, that spirit and that soul of culture, it really is strong in Jamaica. There's a very strong sense of culture and spirit that, you know, nothing can defeat you. Like, Jamaican people are one of the strongest people that I've ever got to, you know, be around. Honestly, like, there's so much hardship there, but you would never know it, because, like, they just show such of an energy and life that, you know, you can't find anywhere else. There's no other place on earth like it. And, you know, I travel a lot, and I can tell you that going to Jamaica is always a unique experience. And I'll always be appreciative that I was born there. Now, I don't speak patois anymore. I understand some of it. I would say I understand about 30% of it. But patois is different, because depending on the different region you live in, it changes, right? And there's people that speak it faster, and there's, you know, people that speak it slow. Like, if you speak to someone, if I hear someone speak that has actual patois that's like super fast, I will not understand anything. But like, when I go back in my family, and the way where we grew up, I can understand them, because my ears are trained to learn. But yeah, it's very Interesting. But yeah, we're gonna learn some facts today. Let's get right into some of these facts that maybe our lesbian knew, or maybe I know some of this stuff. So the first fact from Jamaica is that we are the fastest runners on earth. So everyone knows Usain Bolt, one of the most iconic athletes in the world, and he's from Jamaica. Now, people, they ask, why are Jamaican runners so fast? I don't know. To be honest, I just think that we have to, like, if you look at Jamaica, like, we don't have an infrastructure that's set up where we take the train, so, like, a lot of us walk a lot. So maybe that has something to do with it, but honestly, I have no idea. I couldn't tell you. The second thing is that Jamaica produces the most music per capita, which is true. A lot of Jamaicans love music, and not just reggae, like rock and roll and different types of genres. But reggae is, like, obviously a very popular genre all over the world. I don't know the history of how it became so big. Obviously, Bob Marley is a big factor of that. But there's so many reggae artists, and reggae has so many different branches of it, just like hip-hop and any other genre. I listen to reggae myself. That's actually my second favorite genre. First is hip-hop. Jamaica has the most churches per square mile. I did not know that. Now, I knew that Jamaicans are actually really religious. There's a lot of Christians in there. There's a lot of, I think there's Catholics and different branches of that. This small town is home to well over 30 established churches. We don't know, Jamaica definitely has a bunch of churches. Definitely know that for a fact. Rumbas. Jamaica also has the most rumbas, which is true. So I have this funny story where the last time I went to Jamaica, right? I basically met this guy, and he was literally, like, I would say 80 years old. I mean, the guy had no teeth, but basically he would take a whole bottle of Jamaican rum. I'm talking about, like, a bottle like this big, right? And, like, just down the thing. And I'm like, how are you still functioning? Like, it was, I couldn't even take a sip of it. Like, you, as soon as you open a bottle of rum, you smell it throughout the air. Like, I don't know if you ever smelled Jamaican rum, but a lot of, when I was growing up, my mom would take that Jamaican rum, like a small bottle of it, you know what I mean, and like rub it on your back if you ever had like shivers or you were sick, and it would literally work. Like, that, I don't know what that thing is. It's definitely like, it's some type of poison in my opinion. But I knew people that used to just drink straight rum. And me personally, rum is good when you mix it with some stuff. Like, rum cake is good. Rum can be used in many different baking methods. But, like, drinking straight rum, I'm like, I will never understand why people like that stuff. Obviously, Jamaica is a top consumer of cranberry per capita. So I didn't know that. That's pretty interesting. Jamaica has a bobsled team. So a lot of people don't know what bobsled is. Bobsled is basically, it's like, it looks like a roller coaster, but you're basically using your momentum, and you're working as a team to move fast and navigate throughout a course. There's more to it, obviously, because bobsled has a history to it, but yeah, it's definitely a big Jamaican thing. Me personally, I've never went bobsledding. I definitely want to try it, see how that is. The James Bond series was written in Jamaica, which is true. I actually knew that James Bond in Jamaica actually has a very close relationship and tie. I didn't know exactly what it was, but that is very true. And so the next one is, Jamaica was once a Spanish-speaking country. I also knew this. There's a town in Jamaica called Spanish Town. So I kind of figured that, you know, Spanish language had a big influence in Jamaica. Which is weird, because you don't really see a lot of Spanish people, but there is a lot of people in Jamaica that do actually speak Spanish, which is good. Jamaica is the home, I like this fact. So it says Jamaica is the home of beautiful women. Is that really a fact? Like, any country you go to, there's gonna be beautiful women there, right? I will say though, that when it's so different, because when you go to Jamaica, you don't see a lot of overweight people. Like, it's just, you just don't see it. Like, every time I go to Jamaica, I never see, like, overweight people. I don't know if it's just the areas I go, but, like, you come to America and it's, like, a normal thing. So it's just a big cultural difference in terms of, like, the type of people you see. Mind you, Jamaica has a lot of, like, fast food in certain areas, but the people's ideas of that type of eating, they know that it's not, they're more conscious of what they consume. Everything's organic and fresh, and they prefer that. Jamaica supports equal rights for humanity. Well, that's good to know. I would hope that they would support that. Yep, that's basically what they told me. So basically, most of the stuff I knew. So for me, I'm gonna share some facts that I know about my country. So Jamaica actually has this bridge. I don't remember the name of it, but if you type in like Jamaican bridge, I'm sure it will come up. It's a small bridge and it leads over a river. Apparently this bridge has no railing. So like literally if you make one like sharp turn or you make a little bit of mistake in terms of like driving, you actually fall into the river. And there's actually history of people actually dying from this. Now mind you, when you fall, the river is not, it's not like it's super high, but like I think the speed of it and the type of tides makes it like super deadly. But anyway, trucks with like actual trucks that drop like fruits and produce would actually like go over this bridge. So like you would have to be the most skilled driver to actually get across the bridge. That's an interesting fact. The reason why I know this, because when I went to Jamaica, every time I go back to my hometown, I would have to drive over a bridge. My hometown is actually Spanish Town, and that's where I grew up. But yeah, I used to drive over this bridge to get to drive up the hills to get to where I used to live at. But you know, Jamaica is definitely a great country. A lot of people don't understand that. When you go to Jamaica and you stay at a resort or a hotel by the beach, yes, that's like the ideal place that most tourists would want to go, which I'm not blaming anyone. But just realize that when you go there, you're not really experiencing the Jamaican culture, right? So literally like going to a Jamaican resort is just like going to any other resort at a nice tropical in the Bahamas place. Like you're literally seeing the ocean, right? You're literally listening to reggae, which is great, but the food that they have at the resort is not the actual authentic Jamaican cuisine. I recommend that you find a safe way to visit some of the local places, because you will really experience the culture. Like besides like seeing the people, you will actually get to see the food, you actually shop and see how people shop, you'll get to see what it's like to live a Jamaican lifestyle. Because when you go to the resort, you don't really see that. Like no one that lives in Jamaica, as far as I know, in the towns that I'm from, has a life that is like the resort. Like everything's catered to you, you know what I mean? Jamaica's about self-sufficiency, working hard, providing for your family, and I got to really experience that. So I'll never like take that for granted. Occasionally I go to a resort, but I will always have to like leave the resort and like go back. And it's not just because I'm from there, it's because I realize the value and perspective it gives to you. Now, the way I want to end this video is just by giving you guys this last advice. When I go to Jamaica, the main thing that I take away is that life is not about possessions. And the reason why I say this, because when you go to Jamaica, it's very simple lifestyle. They don't really care about having a lot of things. Now, a lot of people don't have a lot of things, but they are way more happy. They have way more fulfilling things, like family, friends, love, laughter, things like that actually sustain them. And you can tell it through the people. They just have an energy about them. Not to say that they don't want money, but they don't have it and they already found happiness without it. And here's my last thing. Every time I go there, I always appreciate everything I have more, because I realize that there's so much abundance in America that a lot of people they take for granted and we complain about. But like every time I go there, I'm like, yeah, no, I'm working hard to give back and help others. And it's something that I have to remind myself. I have a great time going there, but I will never forget, like, that's where I came from. And my goal is to eventually become wealthy so I can help that country and build it up to where it needs to be. And that's how I'm going to end the video. I wanted to shoot a video today just to inform and talk a little bit about the place that I'm from. And there's going to be more videos like this, but this is a one-of-one. Thank you and have a great day. Stay positive. And don't worry about a thing. All right, that's it for today. Peace.